Good day to you.
It's all but spent. The crystals we get from the tree. What can I interest you in today? Hope it's to your liking. Here's what we agreed on. Keep fighting the good fight.
If you ever need a room, Sid, just say the word. I'll have a bed made up while you eat, and that goes for your friends too.
You're quite talented with that rod of yours.
Typical nobles.
Carry
Good day to you.
Yeah! Griffins don't exactly make for easy prey. Let's hope our craftsman hasn't bitten off more than he can chew.
Look sharp.
Something there, boy. Could that be our man? Oh, cool. That's better. Are you all right?
Yeah. Dare say I'll survive. That griffin caught me before I could get an arrow off. Must have lost sight of me in the grass, though. I'd be dead if it hadn't.
More likely than not.
The name's Camille. I'm a lowly leather worker, if you couldn't tell by the smell of me.
Not so lowly from what I hear. Do you remember selling to a merchant by the name of Karen?
She's not an easy woman to forget. Bought a cuirass from me after I lost my buyer. Quite taken with my work, as far as I recall. Didn't stop her bartering me down to a pittance, though. She sent you for a refund.
It's not her who sent me.
Well, consider me flattered.
You should be. He's a master of his art, and not an easy man to impress.
Blacksmiths are proud folk. It's a rare thing indeed for one to praise a glorified tanner. And I don't imagine an impressive swordsman like yourself would be getting your steel from any but the best. I'd dearly love to help a fellow craftsman, but... Well, actually, I suppose you could give him this.
What is it?
Treated leather. Same stuff I used to make that cuirass. If your man's as skilled as he sounds, he'll know what he's looking at.
You sure?
Well, you did save my life. And thanks to you, I'll be going home with all the griffin hide I can carry. I'd say it's the least I can do. Short of showing him how to make the thing myself, that is. But there are rules against it. Secrets of the trade and whatnot.
In that case, I'll see that he gets it.
I'd be much obliged if you would. Right, I've got some greaves to make. You send your blacksmith my regards.
Will do. And thank you. Hopefully this will sweeten Blackthorn's mood. Let's go.
Nobles. Karen. That monster's taken quite a liking to Lady.
And with a bit of luck, Clive might even find the geezer.
Bloody busybodies, the both of you.
How'd it go, Clive? Did you find him, or does the hunt continue?
I found him. And he asked me to give you this, along with his regards.
You're joking.
He said he wouldn't teach you how to work it, but that if you were as skilled as you sounded, you'd have no trouble understanding how it was done.
So that's his secret. Crafty bastard. He's layered and cross-grained it. Good few times, too. No wonder it's tough. And that's no ordinary oil he's used to get that finish. Oh, this is fine work. Even finer than I thought.
Yeah? I'll take your word for it. Just looks like leather to me. Still, I'm glad you're happy. Here, Clive, you didn't happen to catch the fella's name, did you?
Camille, I believe.
I thought as much. There ain't many leather workers in the realm daft enough to do their own hunting, see? And his name kept cropping up when I was asking around. Turns out he's from Tabor. And again, most leather workers are. But our friend Camille guards a long-held family secret, the details of which are the subject of some debate in the leather-working community.
Then we better keep this close to our chests.
Listen, sorry for putting the both of you to all that trouble. Should have kept my moaning to myself. Still, I'm glad you found him. This has cheered me right up.
That was the idea. Clive's idea, anyway. He did most of the work.
It's good to have you back, Blackthorn.
Just don't expect me to go turning out work like this. There's a reason he does his own hunting. He knows exactly what hides to look for. And that's how he gets them to layer up so nicely. And don't get me started on how much oiling this leather would need. But I reckon I can make something about as good. Something a Cursebreaker will have no trouble caring for. Anyway, enough narrowing. I've got work to be getting on with.
Looks like we won't be needing a new blacksmith.
As if there was a better one out there. Nah, it wouldn't have been the same anyway. No one spins a yarn like old Blackthorn in his cups. Right, now that's sorted, I've got duties to attend to. Thanks, Clive. You've given me my mate back.
Back, are ya? What's that for you, dear?
Typical nobles.
Run like the wind.
You deserve a rest. Let's go. Fly, Ambrosia. To fight.
Morgul, kill!
Come on. Straight home now. No mistakes.
Morgul, kill! Waken!
Ready, girl?
Yeah!
Back to the stables, girl. You deserve a rest. Come on. You deserve a rest.
Ready, go? Straight home now.
Yeah.